I'm sure that no one has missed the fact that vegan dieting is becoming more and more popular each and every day. So there couldn't possibly be a better time than right now for making a movie covering whether you can perform at your absolute highest level as an athlete while being on a vegan diet. And this is exactly what the Top Shot producers James Cameron, Arnold Schwarzenegger, and Jackie Chan capitalized on by creating the movie The Game Changers. In this viral movie, the producers endorse messages such as the best sources of protein is plants, that meat causes cancer, inflammation, and cardiovascular disease, and that the vegan diet is the healthiest diet on the planet. But is this really true? Is a vegan diet with plant-based protein actually better for performance? And is it healthier than a diet including animal protein? Well, if we start by looking at the health part first, it's clear that in the Game Changers documentary, they more or less cherry-picked studies that argued for the fact that meat causes cancer, inflammation, and cardiovascular disease. But when looking at the totality of evidence done on meat consumption, it actually tells a whole different story. For one, the Annals of Internal Medicine just recently published what seems to be the most comprehensive review on the health effects of red meat. In the article, they weighed the evidence of 5 new systematic reviews done on the current literature and concluded that there is insufficient evidence to reduce red meat intake for health reasons. Not only that, a very recent meta-analysis by Handel et al. Just concluded that past associations between meat and even processed red meat and negative health effects are actually highly biased and of poor methodological quality. So what can be said about meat consumption is that it's not necessarily bad for health in and of itself. It's the absence of veggies in the modern Western diet that causes health problems. This is also why in some studies the average vegan or vegetarian seems to be more healthy than the average meat eater. In fact, in many studies they actually see that vegan and vegetarian groups have lower body fat percentages, higher fiber intakes, higher vitamin intakes, and higher intakes of antioxidants than the meat eating groups. But this simply comes down to the fact that the average vegan or vegetarian, for one, eat more plant-based foods, which automatically increases the intake of veggies, and two, are on average more health conscious to begin with than the average meat eater are. This means that the average vegan or vegetarian are more likely to exercise regularly, think more consciously about what they eat, and probably care more about recovery and sleep, etc., than what the average meat eater does. So it's not that a diet including meat is unhealthy, but more so a diet absent of veggies. And to spur some additional research into the pot, we can look at studies comparing all-cause mortality rates between vegetarians and omnivores, just to find that they all have produced mixed results and that in the grand scheme of things, it doesn't seem to be any difference when it comes to all-cause mortality between the two groups. For example, in this cohort study, vegetarians in the UK had similar all-cause mortality as comparable meat eaters. And if we look at this older review of prospective studies, they also found similar all-cause mortality rates in vegetarian and meat eaters. And then we have this review of vegetarianism in Austria, where they found that a vegetarian diet is associated with poorer health, with higher incidences of cancer, allergies, mental health disorders, a higher need for healthcare, and poorer quality of life. This is in spite of vegetarians overall being leaner and consuming less alcohol than meat eaters. While we have another review where the opposite was found, i.e. a lower all-cause mortality in vegetarians than omnivores, mostly due to improved cardiovascular health. And these mixed results actually makes perfect sense if we look at the health effects of each food group individually. Because while plants offer certain health benefits and nutrients, animal foods do too. While plants shine in terms of like vitamins, antioxidants, and phytochemicals, animal foods have a higher protein quality and are typically richer in bioavailable minerals, specifically iron, and also in beneficial fatty acids like omega-3s and B vitamins. So if anything, it looks like the healthiest diet would be one that is plant-based, but also includes some animal foods as well. And this has also been shown in multiple studies where they've seen that by adding animal foods to a vegan or vegetarian diet, they effectively reduce the risk of nutrient deficiencies. So for health reasons, it looks like flexitarian type diets, where the diet contains both plant-based and animal-based sources, are healthier than a strict vegan diet. So if we come back to the movie The Game Changer, it becomes clear that they cherry-picked studies that would fit their agenda perfectly, i.e. studies that support a vegan and vegetarian diets to be way more healthy than diets including meat. Okay, but what if we move away from health for a while and look at performance instead? Then the biggest focus in the Game Changers is of course on protein. Both in the movie and also on their website, they state that the best sources of protein comes from plants. But again, this is cherry picking and strawman attacking at its finest. Because the truth is that it's been shown by several studies and reviews that animal protein is in fact superior or at worst equally effective as plant protein when it comes to recovery, strength and muscle growth. In a study by Campbell et al., they compared strength training men that consumed either a lacto-ovo vegetarian diet or an omnivorous diet where 50% of the protein came from meat, and they found that the meat eaters gained significantly more muscle. In another study by Hobb et al., they put two groups of strength training men on 0.6 grams of protein per kg of body weight from beef in group 1 and from soy protein in group 2. They found that the absolute increase in muscle cross-sectional area was 50% larger in the beef group at 6% versus 4.2% in the soy group. And if we look at yet another study by Hartman et al., we can see that milk is better for muscle growth than the same macros from soy protein. So it's very clear that by looking at the totality of evidence that animal protein is more effective at increasing strength and muscle mass. But that there is absolutely no problem at all building muscle and strength on a plant-based diet either. The only difference is that for plant-based protein to be as effective as animal protein, the quantities needs to be around 10 to 15% higher of plant-based protein. Now, with this said, I want to bring up something that the creators of the Game Changers movie does very well, which is attacking a straw man. So for all of you out there who wonder, what the heck does attacking a straw man mean? Well, attacking a straw man is a form of argument and an informal fallacy based on giving the impression of refuting an opponent's argument while actually refuting an argument that was not presented by that opponent. In other words, the way to win an argument against strong science is to 1. Ignore the real argument, 2. Create a pretend argument, 3. Defeat the pretend argument, and 4. Claim victory over the real argument. To give you an example of this, both in the Game Changers trailer and in the movie itself, they put a big focus on the notion that it's in fact a truth amongst trainees that people can't perform as vegans because they get too little protein.
You hit like a vegetarian.
Basically what they are saying is that it's a truth that vegans can't perform at all and that they try their best to defeat this pretend argument. But the fact is that the statement that vegans can't perform just as well as meat eaters is completely wrong. I mean, nobody with decent knowledge in the field of nutrition would say something so categorical. So instead of simply accepting the truth of the current evidence, which is that animal proteins are more effective when it comes to performance and recovery, but that people can still perform and recover just as well with plant-based protein as long as they eat slightly higher quantities, they instead try to prove that plant-based proteins are superior by fighting the made-up argument that people can't perform as vegans because they get too little protein. Attacking a strawman in this way is a rhetorical technique that causes people, and in this case we who are watching the movie, to want to join the fight against the made-up argument simply because the real argument can't be beaten. Okay, so now the question becomes, does the end justify the means? What I mean with this is that movies like The Game Changer can certainly help fight against animal cruelty as well as help improve the environment. So does the cherry-picking of research used to fuel The Game Changers actually justify the end? The fact that millions of animals get slaughtered every day just for our own benefit is in my eyes such a terrible act, and is the reason why I've personally been vegan for the past year and a half. And if we also look at environment, statistical evidence shows that the agriculture sector stands for the second largest greenhouse gas emissions in the world, just 1% behind the electricity and heat production sector. So we know that for both environmental reasons as well for ethical reasons, eating less meat is extremely beneficial. So in a way, I still find the Game Changers movie as motivational and inspirational for these reasons. But I don't like that they are not presenting the correct data when it comes to health and performance. But I can understand the reasoning for this as well. The fact is that in order to change human behavior, which in this instance would be to get us to eat less meat, most people need to be motivated on a personal level. And this is in all likelihood the reason why the producers of movies similar to The Game Changers choose to portray health and performance research in a skewed way. Simply because very few people would listen to the message if they wouldn't receive personal health or performance enhancing effects from the information provided. Now, I don't know the true agenda behind making The Game Changers. Perhaps they are only out for money since veganism is all the buzz at the moment. Perhaps they have a more ethical agenda behind creating the video, for instance, to stop animal cruelty and or help improve our environment, or perhaps it's all of these things. But no matter what, I still think it's a movie worth watching for entertainment and for motivation to eat less meat. But it's not a movie to watch if you want to boost your health and performance. Okay guys, so this is going to wrap this video up. I hope that you really liked it. And if you liked the video, make sure you press the like button below and also subscribe to my channel for more videos coming your way. So I will see you guys next Monday. Bye.